there's one certainty in life that you are going to die. I love sitting here on this bench under my tree, and when I pass, this is where I want my ashes to be. I decided to join the police force in 1974, and I really didn't have a clue what I was getting in for. I ended up in licensing, gaming and vice, where I played a prostitute a lot. I used to stand on the corners and get the gutter crawlers to come around and get us. That was an eye-opener, but it was quite fun. Over the past 16 years, I've been pretty sick. I've actually died 5 times and been brought back to life by devices and modern medicine.
Christine's a remarkable person. I met her last year when she was sent down for an assessment because she had a very bad leaking mitral valve.
She had had previous thoracic surgery with, she's had esophageal cancer. She had a cardiomyopathy, and she'd also had a biventricular pacemaker and implantable defibrillator, and in fact had been refused open heart surgery.
I got a letter in the mail from this major Melbourne hospital. It says you can't have the valve operation because you're too weak. You know, you wouldn't survive it. And it was just, I don't know, it's the sort of thing, letter you never want to get. You never want to see it in black and white. You never want to see it in writing. It's pretty daunting when you face your own mortality.
She had a very positive attitude to life and was very keen to explore new and innovative options for treating her mitral valve disease. We were very fortunate to be able to offer her transcatheter mitral valve replacement.
We're very proud to be able to bring our clinical innovation and technology to the Alfred, because they are a leading cardiac site across all of Australia. The structural heart program is an example of the integration between our image-guided therapy and ultrasound products.
The echo navigator is a useful device. We get precise information from our echo pictures that we can precisely correlate with our fluoroscopy images so that we can know exactly where we're positioning our devices. We can be very precise. Christine was a great candidate for this novel device because of her high-risk features.
If it wasn't for that equipment, they wouldn't be able to do my surgery. You know, all right, you've got your brilliant surgeons, I've got the new valve, but if they weren't able to see where they were putting it and what they were doing, I mean, because of this Philips equipment that was monitoring me, it was able to be done in the first place.
The whole aim of these technologies is to get people out of hospital faster with less discomfort.
I just feel so privileged being able to just sit here and live life and look at all the beauty around me. I don't fear death at all. I'm just not ready to go yet.
Innovation and you. Philips.